Action packed start. Oh boy, that did not do a lot. Why are there so many enemies?
All buster for ya!
Yeah. I saw what I was trying to do there, didn't you? Knock him off the map. No, but if they go through the death barrier, they'll still die. You know? I did not realize he was the last enemy, but there was one more around the corner. Good, especially Persona. Yeah.
The best I had was, you sure aren't number one, Skag. Which kind of sucked.
Not as much as that joke.
I got nothing for you. Such is the price of completionism.
In general.
I'm sure someone can edit whatever movie it is.
Almost dead? I can fix that.
This hunt shall be a bit tricky, I fear. You'll need pheromones to attract a fearsome stalker known as Bloodtail. I've got some pheromone vials nearby. Grab one, would you? Oh, Lord, I can smell it from here. Don't open that vial until you're near Bloodtail's lair. The pheromones will only last a little while. If they wear off before you've killed Bloodtail, you'll need to grab some more.
You will find better merchandise anywhere else. I made sure of that. Thanks for the stretch.
Come once back you. Anytime. they just call it that, so simplicity's sake. No.
Vault Hunter, quick suggestion. Just stop teasing me. I've already found my secret weapon, and I'm activating it now, so... You know, you're already too late. No need to head to the Terminus and kill me. No reason whatsoever.
Shield. Big skull. Anytime we come into one of these like arena looking areas, I keep thinking, this isn't Veracidus, is it? Eventually. Not yet. No. Oh. What, Chrysalis? Both did wonders against the side one, but then got to the side. Why are still such a big shock? Oh, I just only tweaked on now where that it's robot fighting time comes from. It's the American equivalent of Robot Wars BattleBots. So it is. You know where you have two teams of humans remote controlling a mechanical robot? It's Robot Fighting Time, I'm pretty sure it's BattleBot. And then the UK equivalent Robot Wars is it's 3-2-1 activate. So it is. I think we actually have to search for it the first time. Hang on, before we do, hang on. So we're done for this small sub area. Excellent. They look good, great from a distance, but as soon as you start digging into them, though, you'll be thoroughly disappointed. Similar. These buggers can web you. You aren't dehydrated, are you?
Oh, he's lovely. Kill him.
Oh, turtle shield.
Well, not indeed. I have financial compensation with your name on it. It's return to me.
Slowly chipping away. Look at my thing.
And now you're tracking the most dangerous game of all.
None. Solid texture. They get no time. Did you open the chest? Or... No, I was going to, but then I got knocked through it because it's like, ooh, non-solid texture. Maybe it's to do with the fact that you didn't like nail shutters or didn't have to like barricade your door or something. I don't know, something I can think of. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I only learned quite recently where the meaning of the phrase blowing smoke up someone's arse comes from. It comes from the late 18th century practice, so late 1700s. Oh. No, it doesn't. It's to do if somebody is drowning or was drowned, what do you do to revive them? Is they would have these special bellows with a compartment that you put tobacco in, light the tobacco, pump the bellows, insert one end up the person's back end, and pump them full of tobacco smoke in order to revive them or wake them up. And that apparently is where the phrase blowing smoke up, you know, your own arse comes from.
You're still coming for me? Okay, release the
because it didn't know any better back then. You know, this is, like I said, late 18th century, so, you know, late 1700s. There's these special bellows. Like I said, they had a compartment in them. So you put tobacco in the compartment, lit it on fire, create smoke, and it's used to provide people who are drowning. Sighted blind. Apparently, as I are. The things you learn from the BBC program AI. Yeah, weird. Why does this elite savage appear to have the master prince in
charge?
Those were literally my best guns!
Yeah. Oh, there's, I was going to say, don't you know, the ammo crate is back there. How you get the damn power boy? Can't remember. Yes, three of them being real bosses. Technically, you know. He doesn't technically have the, you know, username and the big health bar, but in my end he's counted as a freaking real boss. Just because of how bugger annoying he is to spawn. I'm referring to Omidomidoc. You can only get by having a witch doctor. I don't know. I know they have to be a bad. Yeah, by having the witch doctor evolve a badass savage. Either three or four times, I can't remember. Yeah, it's the witch doctors. Yeah, and then you get, you know, triple O on my dumb doctor spawn. Like I said, not classified as a rare boss, but he is in my eyes. Yeah. If you get incredibly lucky or unlucky, depending on your perspective, yeah. Yeah, he is the, in my mind, the most annoying enemy to both spawn and farm. He's also the only Borderlands 2 enemy that I've never seen a live stream of somebody spawning and defeating him, or that we spawned and defeated to define knowing he is. Really? No. Probably. I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, it's enough to look like it. Yeah. Yeah, he has like an absolute flipping truck to a dog. Well, not really him, the black thing, but the taxi dog. Oh yeah. Yeah, no, that's a strong as well. Probably not. Yeah. I mean, funny enough, the Twister is actually the name of the Jacob's shock exclusive shotgun he drops. Yeah, that's more actually used in the command allows than the fight to sanctuary, actually. Mine going forward. Look like then mine going forward. Yeah, I'm down here. Can I miss the jump? Trying to probably make my way up. Pretty much these enemies are gone. Yeah, that's a no. Yeah. Slowly making my way back up the mountain. Oh yeah, hang on. Stay there a moment. Let me see. Oh, you already have that one, don't you? Indeed. Oh, there's a shock witch there, by the way, to the left. I was gonna say which one. No. No. Yeah. Yeah, no, that's why I shot with this here when I was like, oh, that's a great wall. Yeah, no, it's great. You never seen the way you were. Because of my build, I regenerate all ammo except for walking on through ammo. Oh, okay. Yeah. I think third playthrough, I have a feeling it's one of the ones where it starts at 50, yeah, and then as you level up, you can go back and farm them. Not everything does that, but I know, I think it'll mobile do that. I know the Zaffer Toadunk one does. No, I say no, it's like 10,000 capacity, minus 2k health. There's a green down below that's better. If you're gonna total up, that one's decent, but it's too risky. Oh. Oh dear. It's because I think he dropped skins. Yeah, no, that's a fair... Yeah, we're good. Yeah. No, I think he does. I mean, it could be wrong, but I have a feeling he does. It's tricky though.
Hey, while I've got you here, have you considered not killing all my bandit brothers? I mean, just letting us murder you and steal your stuff. Call it over.
Yeah, no. I suppose that worked. Original Dead Island. So I was for the legendary craftable gear, and it's both of them are wrong. Yeah, it's for like the gauntlet or something like that. Yeah, just like find this mine thing in a specific way. But the guy said you had to like trade diamonds for it or something weird like that. Ah, that was it. Yeah, no, it was completely different location. Yeah.
Oh,
see if I do quite the chainsaw guy. Different gas from Dead Island. Yeah, I think so. You can see them, I'm about to go down. Oh, oh, no. Oh yeah, it's gonna save my life.
Worry not, citizen. I'll save you.
Ladybug. Something seems off about this statue. Yeah, he's gonna say the real person. This is in the first of the
others.
In case anybody's wondering why I immediately jumped away from that after pushing the button, is because I didn't know if it was going to explode or not. That's why I jumped away like that. Do we have shock weapons? Good. See the transformers in the top? Oh, there we go, one exploded. chest, or did that happen? In the ion shield?
Cover me,
oh no!
Ah! They probably doesn't have any bugs. You don't know? OP-10, Hyperion, and the other one, Dexedrius, I've got double the HP. This guy's just incredibly tanky, and you have to hit him in his weak spot. But it is less than 80 billion. I hope he can guarantee that. Fighting this bugger with cream must be a right way to end. The yellow jacket. I am taking that. Which means I am staying there, where are you? It was. There you go. That was from the assassins. So it was, you see, whenever we did the level 33, I think, or 35. But yeah, something like that. But yeah, no, there's that. Lasted me a brave while. Sure did. Oh, this part.
Okay. I'm totally terrified right now. But I think I've still got a chance to stop you, Vault Hunter. You may be a walking apocalypse, but I've got my brains, and my guns, and this ship! I may just have a chance again!
This is what I was referring to last episode.
Oh God, what?
Exemplary, Vault Hunter! Now, go collect the fruits of your labors from the Terminus!
Oh, it's one of these. I can walk with this. Shoots orbs. That's a medium, but I can walk with that. No. Before we open these, do you have the rare lichens artifact on? Good. Oh, that's the end of the DLC. Wow. Incredible. Yeah, babe. two rear bosses, side quest, the rare one, and then the Arizona. We also as well though have got one other blue rarity red text Jacob's weapon to try and get the damn cowboy. I mean, it's the only other Jacob's weapon that has a fire rate limiter on it. The Elephant Gun Direct and the damn cowboy in Borderlands 2, they're the only Jacob's weapons that actually do not fire as fast as you can mash the trigger. No, I mean, as a gunslinger, I always prefer using the torpedo. Santor and what element? So Sniper's Amigo, what's your plan for pistol? Avenger, but I'm not sure. No. We know in the final difficulty everything scales up to 50 and then it's your own level. So it goes. Including DLC, which, as I mentioned earlier, leaves you in the weird spot where you go through and reach level 80 on the third playthrough difficulty. All of a sudden, everything will jump from 50 right up to 80. So, you know, it's possible. Not many people do that though. Especially for the Tiny Tina one. Because most people are resetting that, trying to reset that playthrough every single level just so they can get the flipping grog and all of all things. Ooh, what's that purple? That's worth a lot of money. Hey, Gunzerker, gold diamond yet. Interesting high capacity booster ones. Hyperion to no. That's what's mine. Pick you up. No. Okay.
I like it. I want it.
That's a TDR. But no, nothing's gonna be direct, by the way. No, there is a TDR though. And that does consume 2 ammo per shot. Yeah, like I said, in terms of raw damage, nothing will really, like, be direct. Ooh, there's some more there. Nope. Ooh, hello. That is beautiful. I'm thinking you can go suck. That's too risky. Because I have 264,000. You share money pickups, but. I mean, there's a nice blue TDR fire. No. Is that right off any good? Basically 3,000. Oh. 4.2 reload, no. I mean, if you want money, pick up the different T-Tag. Yeah, go for it then. Grenades, nope. White Rarity, nope. Oh. Fire rate 0.9, reload speed 4.3, no. You taking that? Yeah, no. Do you want that Hyperion? Okay. Oh, so if you're looking for money, pick up that. That's worth 8 grand. No, 3,300. No. I mean, yeah, no, I'd say grab the, see the E-Tex, the purples, and the, some of the blues. Nope, nope. Well, I mean, you've still got some effects and blues and purples to pick up. Like that. That bandit. And the rally as well, the purple and the melee damage one. Wherever it was. That, yeah, pick that up, that's worth your money. I'm impressed actually with the whole flow normal mode, you know, getting E-Tex and purples. We just used the teleporter, this is basically the... Oh yeah, by the way, also, see living this room? Once per playthrough. So it is. And on that note, I'm going to call it an episode there. Thank you for watching.